Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the shaded pole induction disc type of relay. In this type of relay, the pole is divided into two sections, one with the shaded ring, one without the shaded ring. So the two fluxes are produced in both the sections, and due to the interaction of these two fluxes, torque is produced. So let us study shaded pole induction disc type of relay. Figure shows shaded pole induction disc type of the relay. If we see here, this is the disc. Disc is basically made up of aluminium. Then this is the coil which acts as a source for the actuating quantity. Then here there is the shaded ring. If we see here, the total pole is divided into two sections. This section has a shaded ring. This section does not have the shaded ring. Now let us study in detail this type of relay. The construction of shaded pole type induction disc relay is as shown in figure. It consists of aluminium disc which is free to rotate in the air gap of an electromagnet. So these two poles are made up of electromagnet, and there is a gap between the two poles in which the aluminium disc will rotate. The part of the pole face of each pole is shaded with the help of the copper band or ring. This is called as shaded ring. The total flux phi produced due to the alternating current will get split into the two fluxes which are displaced in time and space due to the shaded ring. So the portion which is having the shaded ring will produce a different flux, and the portion which does not have the shaded ring will produce another flux. And due to the interaction of these two fluxes, the torque will be produced depending on which the disc can rotate. Due to the alternating flux, EMF gets induced in the shaded ring. This EMF will drive the current, which will cause the flux to exist inside the shaded ring. Now this flux will lag the flux in the unshaded portion by an angle alpha. So the two fluxes produced in unshaded portion and shaded portion will be such that the flux in the shaded portion will lag the flux in the unshaded portion by angle alpha. Now let us consider certain parameters. Let phi s be the value of flux in the shaded portion, phi mu be the value of flux in the unshaded portion, es be the EMF induced in the disc due to the flux in the shaded portion, that is phi s. Similarly, e mu equal to EMF induced in the disc due to the flux in the unshaded portion, that is phi mu. Then Is be the value of current which is induced due to Es. I mu is the value of current which is induced due to E mu. Now E mu, that is the EMF induced due to the flux in the unshaded portion phi mu, will lag phi mu by 90 degree, while Es, that is the EMF in the shaded portion due to the flux phi s, will lag behind phi s by 90 degree. Similarly, The current IS will lag ES by small angle beta. Also, the current I mu will lag behind E mu by a small angle beta. This angle is generally neglected and IS and I mu are assumed to be in phase with ES and E mu. Now, let us draw the phasor diagram. First of all, let us draw the two fluxes phi S and phi mu, which are 90 degree apart from each other. So here I have drawn the two fluxes phi S and phi mu. Phi mu leads phi S by angle 90 degree. Now phasor addition of these two fluxes will be resulting flux phi. So let us represent the flux phi. So here we have represented phi, that is the phasor addition of the two fluxes. Now the EMF E mu will lag behind phi mu by 90 degree. So let us represent E mu. First of all, let us represent the two fluxes phi mu and phi s in such a way that phi mu leads phi s by angle alpha. So here I have represented two fluxes phi mu and phi s which are having the phase difference between them alpha. Phi mu is the value of flux in the unshaded portion, whereas phi s is the value of flux in the shaded portion. Now the phasor addition of these two fluxes will give us the resultant flux phi. So let us draw the phasor addition. So here I have represented phi, which is the phasor addition of phi s and phi mu. Now we know that EMF induced, that is E mu, will lag the flux phi mu by 90 degree. So let us represent the value of E mu. So I have represented E mu, which is lagging the flux phi mu by angle 90 degree. We know that current induced due to this EMF, that is I mu, will lag the EMF by angle beta. So let us represent the value of this current. So the current I mu, that is current in the unshaded portion, lags the voltage E mu by angle beta. Similarly, the voltage induced due to the flux phi s will lag the flux by 90 degree. So let us represent the voltage ES. Here I have represented the voltage ES, that is EMF induced in the shaded portion, which lags the phi s, that is the flux of the shaded portion, by 90 degree. Now we know that the current which is produced due to this induced EMF will lag the voltage by angle beta. So let us represent the value of current. So we have represented the current IS, which is the current in the shaded portion, which is lagging the induced EMF ES by angle beta. So in this way, we have drawn the phasor diagram for the shaded pole type induction relay. Now if we neglect the value of beta, then we can write, torque is directly proportional to phi S phi mu sine of alpha, where T is equal to value of torque. Now if we assume that the fluxes phi s and phi mu are proportional to the current, then we can write, so phi s is proportional to current as well as phi mu is proportional to the current, which is the current of the relay coil. Hence we can modify the equation of torque as torque is directly proportional to I square sine of alpha. Now if we want to eliminate the proportionality sign, let us assume a constant. Hence we can write, torque is equal to K multiplied by I square sine of alpha, where K is the value of constant. Now we know that sin alpha is constant for a given value. We can say that torque is proportional to the square of current. Hence, we can modify the equation as therefore, torque is equal to K multiplied by I square. Hence, we can say that in case of shaded pole induction disk type of relay, the torque is directly proportional to the square of the current. In this way, we have studied shaded pole induction disk type of relay. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida and do subscribe our channel eKida. Thank you.